KUKA ConveyorTech, the cooperation between conveyors and robots. That is actually a software that organizes the cooperation of robots and external conveyors. So the software can automatically adapt the actions of the robot and coordinate with the motions of an external conveyor or an assembly line or a conveyor belt in this way. So for example, in this small picture here, we have an application where we have two moving conveyors and they do move without. This one moves continuously, this one stops. So the robot picks the small cart parcels from this conveyor here and synchronizes its movements with this belt and then places them in the larger bins in this conveyor here. It's not necessarily so that this conveyor needs to stop, it could be moving as well. And ConveyorTech is an option package which is sold to Work Visual. So it's installed together with Work Visual and then added to a project. And then when the project is finished, you transfer it to the robot and the option package will then automatically be installed there as well. So what is the benefits of this? Well, it gives us an increased productivity because we don't really need to stop a conveyor to allow the robot to pick from it. But instead, we synchronize the robot movements with the conveyor, regardless of the speed of the conveyor. This could, of course, be programmed manually, especially if the conveyor speed is fixed and known. But on the other hand, it is more efficient to use this option because it's a predefined function. It allows us to synchronize the robots regardless of the speed. That means that the speed of the conveyor may be shifting or varying, and the robot will synchronize with this movement. And it also then, in this case, comes down also to a commissioning with a predefined function. It's usually easier and faster to commission and get started with a project. The risk will be significantly lower than if you would program this functionalities manually. And in fact, it's not only one conveyor that can be monitored. ConveyorTech allows us to actually monitor the speed of up to three external conveyors. And it also keeps track of up to 20 objects on these conveyors. And at quite high moving speeds, the performance is that if the conveyor is moving with 1.5 meters per second, the accuracy of the positioning of the robot is less than 1 millimeter still. And it's not only linear conveyors we're talking about. It can also be circular conveyors, like in the screen we see here. So in this small example, there is a principle of operation. Well, in both cases, we need to have resolvers on both conveyor belts. This feeds the speed of the respective conveyor to the robot. And in case where we, in this example, want to pick a package from this conveyor and place it on this conveyor, we also need a trigger to synchronize the robot in form of, for example, an optical barrier or something similar, which tells us the robot controller and ConveyorTech will then start to track the parcel's movement on the conveyor until it basically leaves the robot's reach. So basically, that is the functionality of the ConveyorTech. It's not so much to talk about. I have a few video examples for applications. Really short ones, so I won't bore you. I will start with one first. I have some technical problems here. I don't know why it's not showing us the video. Oh, here we go. I hope you can all see the video here. So I hope you all saw the video. I have one, and in this example, we saw a circular table where a number of robots were assembling items on some product here, but they were all synchronized and following the rotating table or the rotating conveyor in this part. That would be that it would also synchronize its movement regardless of the movement of the rotating table. I have one more short video to show you here, which is equally short. Okay, I think you saw the video, all of you. In this operation, it's not a normal pick and place, but instead a screwdriver application, which followed the workpiece, regardless of if it stood still or if it was moving. That means that the operation here is quite simple. It's regardless of the movement of the workpiece speed or position. It will follow the object in each case anyway. So on our previous webinars, we've actually showed you how to do some easier settings in the software itself. Today, we will actually do it a little bit another way. There are lots of more information to find. And you can find that at my.kuka and in KUKA Expert. So I will actually try to show you this instead. So I've already logged in to my.kuka. If you don't have your own account here, I can recommend that you register and get your own account here. The address is my.kuka.com. And we roll down the screen a little bit and start the KUKA Expert. Now, here I can type in. In this case, I happen to know the part number for, in this case, KUKA ConveyorTech. And I know this, for example, because it's stated in the offer I got from my salesman, for example. So I search for the part. I get some product information here on KUKA ConveyorTech, which is the product I'm interested in right now. Get a short description, but the most interesting part here is found in the right-hand field here in KUKA Expert, where we got news on the product, we got the documentation, the operating and programming instructions. There is quite a lot of service information of how to calibrate these parts. And there are also a lot of user instructions, FAQs, if you like, of how to use these parts, and also some functional descriptions. So all the documentation you need regarding KUKA ConveyorTech can be found in this way. And of course, this applies to all our products. So this is a very easy information way of searching information, especially if you know the part number of your product. Any questions so far? Either I'm extremely clear or extremely boring today. We'll see. So this basically covers what I was intended to talk to you about today.